So welcome to CET or NEET class biology. We were discussing about reproduction in organisms chapter. We'll continue. This will be the last class for this chapter. This is sixth class we are discussing. Okay. Today, as I told you in last class, we are going to discuss one interesting part in this chapter, which is not there in the textbook, but for NEET, when we discuss little bit more than the textbook, then we have to discuss very interesting topic, cloning. In last class, at the end of the class, I told you, okay, next episode, what will be there? Means next class, means today's class, what will be there? We will discuss about cloning. I told you, cloning means, clone means a copy. Like me, you can produce millions. Millions of Ganesh Shastri you can produce. Okay, or like Narendra Modi, Prime Minister, you can produce millions. All millions will look exactly same like Narendra Modi. Then what happens? What is the problem? Actual or real Narendra Modi, who is a Prime Minister, will lose his identity, isn't it? For example, if you clone me, okay, like me, millions of Ganesh Shastri, like me, you produce, then a real Ganesh Shastri, that is, who is teaching now, okay, I will lose my identity. And there are some issues also which I told you, their DNA, all their millions of clones produced by me, their DNA will be same like me, okay, because they are produced by DNA of my body. My gene is required to produce them. One single cell from my body is enough to produce a clone, okay. So this cloning is done? Cloning is banned. Cloning is illegal. You can't do cloning. Okay. I told you in last class why it is banned. Because person or the actual person loses identity. So let us see who was a scientist first time tried to clone animal or different organisms. So cloning word, clone refers to copy. Okay, a copy means like a photocopy, exactly same. Okay, you know the definition, morphologically and genetically similar individuals like a parent, by asexually produced. But here, cloning, what they do here, we are discussing after sexual reproduction, because it is a type of sexual reproduction only. Okay, so here gamete cells only they use between two different individuals. So it is a type of sexual reproduction only. You will come to know how it is a type of sexual reproduction. Okay, so individual member of a clone, we call it as ramete. I told you in last class, individual member, suppose 50 clones are there, every single clone is called ramete. Okay, the scientist, his name is Ian Wilmot. See, his name Ian Wilmot. He is a scientist in 1997. Okay, first time he cloned a sheep. Animal sheep. Okay, and he named that clone as Dolly. Dolly is a name of clone produced. Clone of a sheep produced. I'll show you the picture how he produced it. Okay, and first cloned plant is strawberry. If you clone a plant, no problem. You can increase number of plants. But cloning procedure, don't think it is very cheap. Naturally, you can produce strawberry, that is cheaper than producing it by cloning. Cloning requires laboratory techniques, and when you use laboratory, then it is costly. Okay, some chemicals are required, then some instruments are required, then it becomes costly. Naturally, growing strawberry is cheap compared to laboratory method. So, Ian Wilmot, he is a father of cloning, means first time he tried to clone a copy of sheep. Okay, then father of human cloning, who tried to clone humans, father of human cloning, Okay, his name is J.B.S. Haldane. Haldane, J.B.S. Haldane. This name you will hear in chapter Evolution also. And you have learned this in 9th standard, if you have learned Evolution chapter. Theory of Chemical Evolution is given by A.I. Oparin, scientist Oparin and Haldane. Okay, in the Evolution chapter they said, all the living organisms are produced by chemicals because our body is made up of chemicals. Okay, what chemicals? Like enzymes are chemicals, hormones are chemicals in our body. Okay, then all other DNA is a chemical, RNA is chemical. So all the chemicals are there in the body, our body is made of chemicals. So anyway, that is not required now, that we will discuss in Evolution chapter. Father of human cloning is J.B.S. Haldane. Okay, he tried to use this in agriculture purpose. You can search this in Google if you want. Father of human cloning, you can search in Google, you will get same answer, J.B.S. Haldane. Anyway, okay, so how Ian Wilmot in 1997 cloned a sheep and produced offspring exactly looks same like parental sheep. Okay, it is a clone of parental sheep. Wilmot gave name called Dolly for that. Okay, so let us see with a picture, because I cannot draw sheep structure and all. See, I'll show you this picture. Okay, so I'm only recording my videos, I'm only handling camera, I only have to focus the camera. Okay, I have to adjust, rotate camera when I shift from one board to other board. Okay, now time is 11 o'clock at night. Okay, only I am recording myself, means I am only using camera and recording. So I take time for turning the camera. For all the classes I do that. Okay, all the neat classes I did same way. Okay, see the picture here. What he did, Ian Wilmot is a name of scientist who cloned sheep. I have written here J.B.S. Haldane is a father of human cloning. Let us see what he did. Okay, he used one sheep. It is black faced sheep. Sheep which has black color face, you can see here. Okay, normal body with black color face, because it is easy to identify the character. What he did, he removed an egg gamete, female gamete egg he removed. Can you see this donor egg? Donor means this is an animal which donates the egg. Okay, then what he did, this pink red color what you see here, orange color, that is a nucleus of the cell. What he does, you know, removed nucleus. Egg of a sheep he took, he will remove nucleus of that egg and make it empty cell. Okay, then one more sheep he used, which is white faced sheep. This is black faced and this is white faced, the sheep which has white face. Okay, this is black face, this is white face. Again he took a cell, normal cell of this white faced sheep. Okay, normal cell he took. What he did, this normal cell and this nucleus removed cell, both he will fuse means eradanu serstane koodstane. Okay, both the cells, see, this is nucleus removed cell and this is normal cell of white faced, both the cells he will fuse. How? Normally cell cannot bind. Okay, it is fused by electricity. He will pass electricity with that force, pulse of electricity, the outer wall of cell breaks and both the cells will fuse. Now what happened, in a empty cell of egg of black face and cell with nucleus of white face, both mixed, then what happened here, if you can see, this is one cell with empty nucleus and nucleus of this cell. Okay, now it is like a mixture of both, mixture of two cells of these two. Okay, one cell without nucleus and one cell with nucleus, both he mixed and it became one cell here, egg fused with cell. then it produced the embryo. Embryo means now kannadadalli bruna antivalla, okay, embryo. Before becoming a baby, okay, it will be an embryo in humans also. Before becoming human baby, it is the stage like 5th month of pregnancy, 6th month of pregnancy, then it is called embryo, okay, like that. So embryo is developed, cell divides and multiplies. See, one cell was there, here three cells are there, multiplied. Then what they do, this embryo, they take it and they will introduce into the female reproductive part of black-faced sheep. Then what happened? All ready-made embryo, they will insert in female reproductive part of black-faced sheep. Then resultant is what? Black-faced sheep with white-faced lamb or clone is produced. What is lamb means? L-A-M-B, lamb. Offspring of sheep is called lamb. Okay. Andre now kuri antivala, kuri marige, now lamb anta karithu. Okay. Offspring of sheep is called lamb. What is produced? Black-faced sheep with white-faced lamb. Okay. So here it is, white-faced lamb produced, which looks exactly same like its parent. So it is a clone of its parent. Okay, this is how they produce. Even in human beings also, you can produce by same method, but you can't produce because it is banned. This process is banned. Okay, if you go to Visveshwaraya Museum in Bangalore, there one machine is there. It will ask whether cloning should be allowed or it should be banned. You should press button yes or no. Most of the people, 90% of the people said yes for banning. Okay, because it is not good. Person loses his identity. So they banned it. Okay, no country will allow cloning now. Okay, then. So let us discuss last part of this chapter now. Anyway, cloning we finished discussing. We will discuss last part of this chapter now. I'll zoom out. Okay, I hope board is clear now. Okay, let us discuss. Okay. Chalk. So let us discuss last part of this chapter, then we'll go to important questions which they asked before in NEET. So this last part is deviations in reproductive strategies. Deviations in reproductive strategies. Something different from natural reproduction. Let us see what happens in plants first, then we'll see in animals. This is what you know, very simple. Normal reproduction happens in all the plants, but in some plants it is slightly different, unique. Okay, so you consider, we are all normal person. Okay, you consider one person who is mental, I mean he is abnormal. Okay, so let us discuss abnormal type of sexual reproduction which is different from normal reproduction. Okay, so what is that? Then it is called as deviation. Deviation means going away from. It is slightly different, abnormal reproduction in plants. What are those abnormal reproduction? Number one, some of that you know, parthenogenesis. You know this process of formation of offsprings without fertilization. Without fertilization, directly egg produces offspring, then it is parthenogenesis. Okay, you know parthenogenesis is different, parthenocarpy is different. Parthenocarpy, carp refers to fruit, pericarp means you know outer wall of fruit. So parthenocarpy means process of producing seedless fruits. Fruits without seeds. We get in the market, you know, seedless grapes. Okay. Like that you can produce seedless watermelon also. because it is very hectic to remove the seeds of watermelon. Okay. So parthenogenesis is one different method than normal reproduction. Normally reproduction happens with fertilization, that is union of male and female gametes. Fertilization happens. This is something different in plants, that is offspring will be produced without fertilization, then it is parthenogenesis. This is one method of deviation. Then parthenocarpy, I told you, process of producing seedless fruits. You know this first year plant growth and development chapter, you have learned plant hormones, you know. Some hormones when you spray, it produces seedless fruits. Okay. So parthenocarpy, do you remember auxins when you spray? Then it produces parthenocarpic seedless fruits. This is also different from normal reproduction, because normally fruits will be there in the seeds will be there in the fruit. This is fruits without seeds. This is abnormal, deviation from reproduction. Then polyembryony, you know this. Polyembryony means, poly means many. Many embryo will be produced. Polyembryon. Usually one embryo will be there in the plant. This is many embryos will be there, like in mango and citrus plants. Okay. So this method was first identified by Anton von Leeuwenhoek. Anton von Leeuwenhoek, scientist, first time he observed polyembryony in plants like mango, then citrus, lemon and all plants. Okay. Then amphimixis, process of reproduction which involves meiosis and syngamy. Amphi means both the processes. Amphimixis, two processes which involves meiosis, reduction division, where chromosome number is reduced to half, where 2n number of chromosomes are reduced to n. Meiosis also happens and syngamy also happens. Syngamy means union of male and female gametes, sperm and egg both fuses, then it is fertilization. Fertilization has other name, that is called syngamy. You can call fertilization as syngamy also. Meiosis also happens, syngamy also happens. If both the process happen, then it is amphimixis. Amphi means both. Amphibian, you know, now ubhayavasigalu anta karitevi. It can live in water also and on land also. So amphimixis means which involves reproduction, which involves both meiosis and syngamy. Then apomixis, where plants reproduce syngamy, okay, but offsprings are produced due to kind of asexual reproduction. Okay, so scientist who gave this method is Rinkler. Apomixis, instead of sexual reproduction, offsprings are produced by asexual method. Okay, then this method was identified by scientist called Rinkler. Okay, so these are deviations of sexual reproduction in plants. Let us see deviations of sexual reproduction in animals. Then this chapter I'll finish. In animals, what about that? Hermaphroditism means, you know, hermaphrodites. You know this word. Hermaphrodite means animal which has both male and female reproductive organ in the same body, like sponges, you know, porifera, phylum porifera, sponges have hermaphroditism, means male and female reproductive organs are produced in the same individual. Sperm and egg both are produced by same organism, then it is hermaphroditism or hermaphrodite. Okay, then neoteny means embryos fail to go through normal metamorphosis and sexual maturity happens in larval stage only. neoteny word. So many times they have asked in AIPMT, All India Pre-Medical Test. Now it is renamed as NEET. Neoteny means embryo of aneura. Aneura is one group of animals. Okay, aneuron embryo fails to undergo metamorphosis. You know what is metamorphosis? Metamorphosis is a change from one form to other form. Like simple example, butterfly, okay, adult butterfly undergoes four stages before it becomes adult. You know, eggs are laid, then pupa, okay, pupa stage is there, larva stage is there, then it becomes adult. Okay, metamorphosis means these changes: first egg, then larva, then pupa, okay, then it will be there in cocoon, then it becomes adult, like in silk moth also. Okay, so that is metamorphosis. So fails to undergo metamorphosis and directly larva directly acts like an adult. Larva matures. Larva, it is like, you know, newborn baby acting like adult. Okay, baby directly becomes adult. Is it possible? It is like giving a driving license at the age of 2 years or 3 years or 4 years. LKG, she can drive car. Okay, it is like that. So larva fails to undergo metamorphosis, directly it becomes adult, then it is neoteny, that process. It is shown in axolotl larva. Axolotl larva of aneura. Aneura is animals, aneurons, members of aneura. Axolotl larva, it is a type of larva where larva directly acts as adult and larva reproduces directly. Possible? It is like human baby reproducing. Baby reproduces? No. Baby should become adult. After getting sexual maturity, it will reproduce. Okay, this is different case in some animals, that is neoteny. Then pygogenesis. Pygogenesis means reproduction by child. It is there in some fishes. Pygogenesis. Child reproduction. Child reproduction means, you know, babies directly reproduce. Possible? Okay, it is like babies producing babies. Babies producing offsprings. Possible? In human beings, it is not possible. Okay, because newborn baby doesn't produce sperm or egg. It is not possible. But in some fishes, some small fishes, this is possible. I mean, newborn fish, small fish, before it matures and becomes big, you know, it directly reproduces. Then the process is called pygogenesis, reproduction by child. Okay, that is different from other method. Then androgenesis and gynogenesis. Androgenesis means, you know, andro means male reproductive part. It is very simple. Androgenesis means fertilization happens, but during fertilization only male reproductive part directly produces offspring. Female reproductive part, I mean female gamete, will get destroyed or it is degenerate. It disappears. I'll give you example. Suppose it is sperm is a male gamete and egg is a female gamete. Okay, andro refers to male reproductive part, gyno refers to female reproductive part. This is male, this is female. Okay, if sperm directly produces offspring, so offspring is produced by andro, means, you know, male reproductive part, where female reproductive part gets degenerated, gets destroyed, disappears. Okay, then offspring is produced by only male part, that then it is androgenesis. Genesis means formation of offspring by ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೇಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅದು ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಬಲ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಫಾದರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಗ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಮದರ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ಓಕೆ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ವೇರ್ ಆಫ್ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಜನರೇಟೆಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆಂಡ್ರೋಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೈನೋಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ಗೈನೋ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಗೈನೇಷಿಯಂ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅದರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಥೆನೋಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಥೆನೋಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಆನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಥೆನೋಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಫ್ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಫಿನಿಷಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಡೂ ಯು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರೀ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಎಗ್ ಮೀಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಯು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಇವೆಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೀ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರೀ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ಮೀಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಶೋ ಯು ಬೈ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಗ್ ವೆನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಮೀಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಎಗ್ ದೆನ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಯು ನೋ ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೂ ಮಿಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ಪ್ರೀ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಶುಡ್ ಮೀಟ್ ಎಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಮೀಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಎಗ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಗ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೊ ಅಂಡರ್ ಪ್ರೀ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಟೂ ಸ್ಟೇಜಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಎಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಟು ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಇನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೈ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೋಲನ್ ಗ್ರೇನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಂಥರ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಿಗ್ಮಾ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸಿಂಗ್ಯಾಮಿ ಅದರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಅಂದರೆ ಭ್ರೂಣ ಅಂತೀವಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಬೇಬಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ವಿ ವೇರ್ ಬೇಬಿ ಒನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ವೇರ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಬರ್ತ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮದರ್ಸ್ ವೂಂಬ್ ವಿ ವೇರ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫಿನಿಶ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಇವನ್ ದೋ ವೆರಿ ಲೆಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 3-4 ಪೇಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ನೀಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ಎಲನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ರಾಜಸ್ಥಾನ್ ಕೋಟಾ ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೀಚ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಲಕ್ಕಿ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಚ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೋಕಸ್ ನೌ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಓಕೆ ಹಾಂ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ನೌ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಇಸ್ an alternation of asexual and sexual reproduction. An alternation of asexual and sexual reproduction, where both the generations are diploid and the haploid stage is represented only by the gametes. It is called what type of reproduction? I repeat the question. An alternation of asexual followed by sexual reproduction, where both the generations are diploid and haploid stage is represented only by the gametes. It is called what? Options: alternation of generation, metagenesis, pedogenesis, parthenogenesis. This is first year. If you remember, we have learnt under Coelenterata, where there are two stages: medusa form and polyp. Okay, polyp produces medusa asexually, medusa produces polyp sexually, then the process is called metagenesis, isn't it? Alternation of generation. Do you remember that? So here, what should be the option then? So it should be think, it should be option B, metagenesis, isn't it? Okay, metagenesis. Then which type of reproduction is found in Hydra? Which type of reproduction is found in Hydra? This you know, very very simple: polyembryony, sexual and asexual, parthenogenesis and encystment. Which type of reproduction happens in Hydra? Polyembryony, sexual or asexual, parthenogenesis, encystment. It should be sexual and asexual reproduction happens in Hydra, because you have learnt one question. Do you remember? One picture was there where Hydra produces sperm and egg. Okay, sperm of one Hydra goes to egg of other. This is one question we discussed on this. That means it has sexual reproduction when it produces sperm and egg. Then we discussed budding method, you know, in Hydra. Budding also is there in Hydra. So budding is asexual. Then it has both sexual and asexual reproduction. Then polyestrous mammal is man, a rabbit, cat and horse. Estrous cycle means, you know, you have learnt in non-primates, a menstrual cycle is also called as estrous cycle. It is not menstrual cycle, it is called estrous cycle. Okay. So polyestrous cycle is there in options: man, rabbit, cat and horse. Which should be the correct answer? It is horse. Polyestrous mammal is horse. Okay. Differentiation in morphology of the two sexes of the same species is called. Differentiation in morphology of the two sexes of the same species is called. Options: hermaphrodite, heteromorphosis, sexual dimorphism, unisexual. Which is correct according to you? See, you should understand every word in the question. Okay, then only you can answer. So neat questions, if you read once you don't understand, you should read it twice at least. Okay, so sexual dimorphism means, sexual dimorphism means one organism showing two different characters, sometimes as male, sometimes as female. Then hetero means different, heteromorphosis. Okay, different, it exists in different structures. So which is correct answer according to you? Okay, it should be sexual dimorphism. That is why they said differentiation in morphology of the two sexes of the same species. Same species shows two different types of reproduction. Then it should be sexual dimorphism. Di means two. Fertilization is internal in toads. Toads means, first year you have learnt all this. Toads, it is dry, land frog. Toads, dry skin. Frogs, fish and catfish. Which is correct? Fertilization is internal in, that is, sea fishes. It is internal. In catfishes, it is external. Toads or frogs, it is external. Because you know, frog, we have learned external fertilization, where frog releases group of eggs on the rocks, okay, in water, like a gel like eggs, many will be there. And male frog releases sperm on the egg outside in water on the rocks. And ನೀರಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲ್ಲು ಇರ್ತದಲ್ಲ, ಕಲ್ಲಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಗ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ, ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್, ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ಟೋಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಫಿಶ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ದ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ಬಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಸ್ಪಾಂಜಸ್, internal buds of fresh water sponges are otherwise called what? Internal buds of fresh water sponges are otherwise called coenocyte, gemmule, osculum and blastula. This question was asked, see, MGIMS Wardha 2010. MGIMS means, you know, Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Medical Science. Wardha is a place, it's a place, okay. They used to conduct separately medical entrance. So in 2010 they asked, so what is that called as, where internal buds of freshwater sponges are otherwise called coenocyte, gemmule, osculum and blastula. What should be the correct answer according to you? It is option B, gemmule. We have already learnt, under unfavorable conditions sponges produce a flask like structure and the buds produced inside, many will be there. It is called histoblast. Do you remember? So that is gemmule. Okay, gemmule formation in sponges are useful in, this also they asked, Wardha only 2010. See, Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Medical Science, Wardha 2010. Gemmule formation in sponges are useful in what? Asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction, parthenogenesis, parthenocarpy. Which method according to you? It is option A, asexual reproduction. Because we have learned gemmule under heading asexual reproduction, different methods. You can see my previous class. On the board I have written gemmule with the diagram also. Okay, so it is very simple question. Then budding is found in Cycon, Hydra, Faciola, Obelia. This direct question, Hydra, you know that. With picture I have explained in the class. Then Hydra reproduces by budding. This is example of what? Regeneration, abnormal development, asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction. Definitely budding is a type of asexual reproduction. So it should be option C. Then see this question, question number 35, 36, 37, they have asked for OJEE exam 2010. OJEE means, you know, Odisha. Orissa means, you know, Odisha it is called. Odisha Joint Entrance Exam, JEE. It is conducted in 2020 also. It is conducted for private medical colleges, especially engineering, medical together. Engineering, medical together, common exam. Joint Entrance Exam conducted by Odisha. NEET is for government seat, you know. For private medical colleges, they used to conduct separate. Okay. So now it is only NEET, you know, but in 2020 Odisha also conduct like CET, how we conduct in Karnataka. Okay, so last question, sexual mode of reproduction in protozoa is again OJEE, Odisha Joint Entrance Exam 2005. Previous question was 2009, its previous question was 2010. Okay, sexual mode of reproduction in protozoa is anisogamy, plasmogamy, plasmotomy, schizogamy. Which is correct option according to you? It is option A, anisogamy. In protozoa, anisogamy means gametes look different, male and female gametes, they look differently. If they look same, then it is isogamy, but here in protozoa they look different. Okay, so with this in detail, with lot of knowledge and lot of information, okay, we finish this chapter. Okay, keep watching my classes. Thank you.